यस वेलकम टू SAP UI5। सो एज द नेम सजेस्ट इट इज UI5। दिस स्टैंड्स फॉर इट्स SAP UI डेवलपमेंट टूल किट। इट इज मोर अबाउट यूजर इंटरफेस। सिंस इट इज मोर अबाउट यूजर इंटरफेस दैट मीन्स द फ्रंट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। सो दिस इज द SAP UI5 डेवलपमेंट टूल किट फॉर HTML5। दैट मीन्स so whatever that can be done through HTML5 to design your web pages, the same thing can be done through SAP also using this SAP's UI technology. So this is SAP's technology to develop the web pages that are supported through HTML5. Maybe you can ask, when HTML5 is already there, so and why SAP UI5 again? Because anyway you are saying finally SAP UI5 is to develop web pages and that are like HTML5. In fact, HTML5 has a limited controls, whereas SAP UI5 has many controls, thousands, hundreds of controls, nearly 500 user interface controls like input field, output fields, button, tabular, etc. So that way SAP wanted to have their own proprietary language, proprietary solution. So that is the reason they came up with SAP UI5. In fact, it is the collection of toolkit for HTML5. That means the same thing that can be done through HTML5, whatever that can be done through HTML5, even more or less the same thing can be done through SAP UI5 also. So what I want you to understand, it is not related to ABAP. It is only to design the web pages like this, so that the prerequisite for learning SAP UI5 is not ABAP. You need not to be an ABAPer, because we are not talking about ABAP. We are talking about designing web pages. That's all. It is only the front end technologies. So no ABAP knowledge is required at all. To be honest, no ABAP knowledge is required. Since it is SAP's technology, so you people are already in SAP, so that we know this news first. We know this news that SAP has a different UI technological UI5. So that we are the people who come to know about this one first, so that we started learning it. So why others are not learning? Just because they don't know that SAP has a UI5 and a better opportunity in SAP. That's the only reason. In fact, you need not have ABAP knowledge just to design your web pages using SAP UI5. So what knowledge is required, we'll see in the further sessions. So that I wanted to understand that it is not for ABAPers. Need not to have an ABAP knowledge. If you have an ABAP knowledge, you can work like a backend developer, where you can interact with the database, where you can get the data from database and put the data into database. But data has to come from the user, so that here is the user and always he needs a user interface. So a UI developer role is up to this. So SAP UI5 is to develop the web applications, web pages like HTML5 pages. Is the definition clear? It is SAP's proprietary HTML5. You can understand like that. It is SAP's proprietary HTML5. SAP's own HTML5. So is the definition clear?
Yes.
Now, so before we get into more technically, so what I want you to understand, a general discussion. Let's get into some general discussion like, yes, yeah. So why actually SAP came with this one? When there are many existing UI technologies in SAP, like SAP GUI, SAP WebDriven Pro, ABAP, WebDriven Pro, Java, etc., etc. When this many UI technologies already there in the market, so what is the need of SAP UI5? So to make it simple, see this. This is how the telephones are evolved, the changes, the improvement from this one, again after this, again from this one. Yes, started from here. In fact, there are many things in between. So this is some diagram I collected, but it seems okay. Started from the oldest to latest here. This is what oldest to latest. Now tell me one thing, what is the actual improvement from the oldest to latest? Still you are making the calls and receiving the calls. So actual improvement from here to here. First one, your user interface is improved a lot. In this scenario, when you want to make a call, when you want to dial a number, if it is 9 digits, so I need to revolve this one, rotate this one for 9 times, I guess. Because in fact, we never come across this kind of, at least I never come across this kind of phone. Because I think, and my journey started with this. Yes, this kind of landlines, I used it. So I'm not sure whether you use any of these landlines. Have you used any of these landlines before this one? I think we are familiar with this kind of landline where you can press the buttons.
No, I did the dial.
Which one? This one, huh?
This, yeah, the black one. The third black one.
Oh, okay, good then. Fine. So I'm now, old. Yes. Yeah, use the red one. Yes, fine. So, yeah, fine. Now you understand. In fact, there is no option to save your contacts here. So every time you need to open your phone book. And then if you miss one number, I can start from the beginning, I guess. If one digit is incorrect. So if you understand that, so it's a very tedious effort. Tedious effort to make a call. Now see the things. Now see the oldest to latest. So what is the improvement I want you to understand? And the user interface becomes much, much, much easier. That's what. That is reason. Nowadays, the kids, 1 year kids, 2 year kids, how they are able to operate this one? So they know how to open everything. Even we are not sure certain options in my phone. But yes, kids are playing like anything. So just because the user interface becomes much, much, much easier when you compare with this one. So the same thing is now. And adapted in SAP also. In SAP also, earlier there is a user interface where we do not have much freedom to provide many options. So first reason, first improvement, I want you to observe two improvements. First improvement is user interface becomes easier. Second improvement is web-based. This is smartphone. These are all not smartphones. Again, here also, even the user interface is a bit okay, but smartphone, smart enough. So like a computer, we can use it. So web applications, you can browse your internet and all. So you can perform all your business activities also from this device. From this device means what? From the applications, via the applications. So you have to develop your applications such a way which can be accessible this kind of devices. So that, for that reason, we have to have your user interface. Because user will interact with the interface first. Your user interface should be lightweighted. So user interface should be developed using the lightweighted language. But till now in SAP, we are using ABAP language. Even WebDyn Pro ABAP, there ABAP came into picture. So ABAP is a heavy-weighted language. Because a language which interacts with the database, we call it as heavy-weighted. ABAP interacts with the database. So we get the data from database, we put the data into database. So, and in SAP UI5, what they made it, they are not using ABAP to develop this web-based user interface. So that they have to have their own language. So a different language, in fact, that's what SAP UI5. Internally, it is a JavaScript. I'll come to that. But here, in general, if you see this one, if you understand how the improvement takes place in the telephone industry, the same improvement we are expecting. Finally, this has the relation with our software, because this is not only this era. This era is not only to make the calls and receive the calls. Yes, here the purpose is only to make and receive the calls. Here. But when it comes to smartphone, the purpose is not only to make and receive calls. The purpose is even to execute your business. How many times you book your tickets from here? How many times you place your order? You're placing an order in Amazon. And if Amazon is using SAP, that's all. So our application should be capable enough to be accessed from the smartphones. For that, our user interface must be smart enough. User interface must be developed using lightweighted language. So that is the reason. There is a need in SAP to develop the user interface as light as possible, but not using ABAP language, so that they come up with their own a separate lightweighted language called SAP UI5. Two points, guys. One is the user interface becomes simple. Second one is this is a smartphone. So where not only just to make and receive calls, it is even to execute your daily activities, not only daily activities, even your business activities. When you are placing an order, that means Amazon is doing its business, isn't it? When you are booking a ticket, that means Redbus is doing the business. When you are booking a railway ticket, that means Railways is doing the business through your phone. So that means the applications that are developed by the Railways, by the Amazon, by the so and so should be able to run and accessible from this kind of devices. For that, we need a separate GUI, not your SAP kind of and traditional GUIs. Is that point clear? Now the phone is not for making and receiving calls, even to execute your business activities. Yes, so that. Yeah. So now come to SAP. This is how the evolution takes place in the telecom industry. Why not in SAP? Because finally, why we are comparing is, yes, we are in this era. This era is just not only make and receive calls, even to execute your business operations. So that our applications must be run on this kind of devices without any performance issues. So that is the reason. It's mandatory for us to redesign the SAP user interface. Yeah, this is how SAP things happens. In fact, this is in very old R2, R3, etc., etc., etc. Now this is the trend where you are able to access your SAP screens via mobiles, your tabs, etc. The user interface must be designed such a way which can run and accessible from this kind of devices. For what? Because business is happening via mobiles now, so that your application should run on the mobiles. That's a simple logic. It's not only now this kind of phones are not only to make and receive calls, guys. So now come to this one. This is how SAP this thing, and don't worry about the exact differences between technology to technology. To make it simple, just like the phone things, instead of worrying about the exact difference between this and this, the end difference between the first one and last one. Similarly here, so better not worry about the exact difference. Usually SAP GUI is for developing web-based, not web-based, desktop-based screens. Then they have the ITS, Internet Transaction Server, and it is a third-party one. And here you cannot design directly your web pages. We have to design the web pages through SAP GUI only. Finally, this will convert into your web pages, so that alignments and all not in our control. However, it generates, we have to go with that. So then WebDriven for Java. So nothing wrong with WebDriven for Java, and it is best suited. But SAP don't want to get Java into this world, SAP world, so that they have WebDriven for ABAP. I can see this. ABAP came into picture to design your web page. HTML should come into picture. HTML should come into picture. Or HTML like technology should come into picture via ABAP. So, and here we use ABAP, WebDriven for ABAP. And of course, internally it will convert into HTML page. It's not internally converts into HTML page. We should be able to and work with HTML pages. We should be able to open the HTML tag. Generally in HTML we say tag. So as per that, because in the HTML if you want input, it should be something like that input. If you want a button, and it should be button. So when you are working with a web page, you should keep these points as relevant points in mind. But in WebDriven for ABAP bundle, we don't keep the HTML library in mind. So through ABAP only we do it. Of course, we have some graphical editor. In the graphical editor, we can drag and drop the things, but still, internally it will be converted as an HTML page. Again, and one of the main advantages here in the UI5 and compared with this one, because they are talking about the programming languages. like about Java and all. But in UI5, they don't talk about back-end languages. They talk about front-end languages. Here, the front-end language is called JavaScript. JavaScript is a language which is supported from every browser. Every browser has an engine, JavaScript engine, built-in engine. So that browser level only this language will be executed. This is also known as a client-side language. Client-side language, user-side language, browser-side language. But here, we don't keep the browser in mind. We simply develop the screen that will run in the browser. But here, we keep the browser in mind, and we keep what browser can understand. Browser can understand HTML5 and JavaScript. So here, we talk about HTML5 and JavaScript. So SAP UI5 is internally a JavaScript library to design HTML5 pages. I repeat, a JavaScript library to design the HTML5 pages. So it's JavaScript, we don't need to install separately. So every browser has a built-in JavaScript engine to understand, to interpret or you compile your these things. And one more main advantage in SAP UI5 is it is responsive. We'll discuss more about the responsive in further sessions. Responsive means the controls what you place here will be adjusted automatically as per your device size. If your device size is mobile, yes. And if the device size is tab, and this control will be adjusted automatically as per your device size. I don't need to code separately. Code once, use it for every device. Not only that, in the UI5, you can define your custom controls. You can extend your standard controls. So there are many predefined templates. So we'll come to that one by one. But this is the journey. But what I want you to understand. So we need a lightweight language. And for designing my web page, none of these are lightweight languages. None of these are. So that is the reason this comes in picture. In fact, outside SAP, other than SAP technologies, they'll use this JavaScript only. JavaScript and HTML5 for developing web pages. Only SAP, actually, they wanted to promote ABAP itself for everything. Now they realized, sorry, it's time to make use of the lightweighted languages, at least for designing my front end. I need to use my lightweight language, because earlier your front end runs on the desktop applications. Now your front end should run on the mobile, not on the laptop. So in that small device, if you wanted to run and show your screen, definitely it should be designed differently, not with the traditional approach. That is the reason. So this is just for the information. So don't worry about the exact differences between this and this. So this is just like moving from landline to smartphone. Yes, please, clear. The main differences, we discuss few of the main differences. This is responsive, and they use a JavaScript because JavaScript is embedded with every browser. Every browser has a JavaScript engine to interpret your JavaScript code, etc. Yes, please, is this clear? Just like moving from landline to your smartphone. Yeah. So now, this is a very general description. Yes, here. This is what SAP UI 5, SAP UI Toolkit, SAP User Interface Toolkit for HTML5. This toolkit, in fact, is designed through JavaScript. That's what some people say. It is SAP's JavaScript library for HTML5. Why for HTML5? Because